Welcome to Microsoft Virtual Academy. I'm Brandon Matherson, and I'm with the Windows Server System Center and Azure Data Center Solutions team focused on helping customers deliver efficient data center management tools to the enterprise and how they actually deliver those services more effectively. So one of the key attributes and key components that we're discussing here in this particular track is IT service management and how do we bring in all of the ITIL and processes that exist in your environment today and take advantage of the technology to help you deliver a better experience for your enterprise users. So as we finish up on the final track or the final segment of this track, it's all about OLA insights and analysis. And we mean these operational insights in terms of helping IT to take an inward view of how we are performing and delivering to make better decisions on adjustments for delivering services back to the enterprise and services that need to be delivered. So what is the value of operational reporting? It's all about internal views and helping us become better in what we deliver and improving our brand. And it's about the operational reports for the IT infrastructure and the resources. Are they performant? Are they up? Are they resilient? Are they stable? And we also want to customize how we share that information and how we provide that view internally as well as externally. We've talked earlier in the SLA insights and reporting. It's all about reporting those insights and those learnings to external teams or executive leadership. Now we have this on the IT leadership team. We want to know what are those trending reports and those issues and those requests and changes and those resources that are consistently coming up in the environment so that we scale appropriately and build out the infrastructure for the future. The importance of this, and when we are more informed, we're able to provide information such as host forecasting and utilization reporting. We're able to provide systemic issues and problems that are coming up time and time again. Operations manager has some reportings that helps us be able to make logical decisions around where we need to scale and where we need to reallocate. And then service manager reporting is all about helping us to understand what changes and needs are out there for us to be able to better meet those challenges. So in this particular view, we want to think about service manager and the capabilities we have there, but also encourage you to take a look at the infrastructure monitoring track to learn more around how we're taking advantage of operations manager to deliver some of that insight as well. So when we enable IT to make proactive decisions, when we do that, it's all about ensuring that they have the right resources available and the key applications and workloads always up and always running. We want to provide a guaranteed levels of services to those users or to those environments. IT has been challenged with demands from the enterprise to say we need to ensure these workloads or these resources or these services or this level of services always up and always on. We want to take advantage of our hardware innovations that we've talked about within the Windows Server investments that we've made to ensure that we have the maximum advantage to scale as we deliver services. When we have those better decisions to make an accurate decision on the current data, IT is better positioned to plan and to scale. We can have extended management for external clouds or clouds beyond just on-premise. That can be public clouds. That could be service provider clouds. We can now charge for those services and charge for that used infrastructure more appropriately. We can then ensure that optimal resources available for key applications and those workloads. So when we do that, we are then able to provide that service as it's been requested in a number of different fashions. So now let me think about the analysis of issues and how will we approach this? How will we think about providing these services to customers? The first thing is we want to think about the planning process that we'll actually have to go through to get this deployed. So we think about capacity planning functions. We need to think about, can we measure or can we provide a scorecard or a metric and predict the future performance? We then want to have fact-based investments in our decisions. Many times we haven't had that. So when we don't have these steps in terms of capacity planning or we don't have these scorecards or these rich views into the performance, we then can't make investment decisions. So then we have budget overruns or we may have underruns or we don't meet the delivery timelines that our customers may demand of us or that our business units may demand of us. So that's why we want to think about how analysis can really help solve this problem for customers. So we're going to bring together our investments and some of our other components within the data center solution set that we have within the cloud and enterprise stack at Microsoft. It's all about SQL Server analysis server is helping us do that. That's a core component of SQL Server where we can bring in those OLAP queues and we can host that information and we can bring those large data sets together in volume and then quickly aggregate that to spit out what is the trends or what is the key behaviors that we're seeing based on that data. And then we can start to provide statistical information and algorithms and then do some forecasting on that information. That's one way that SQL has helped us to really pull that together. Within the system center stack, as we've been thinking about IT service management, as even automation and self-service, it's all about leveraging SQL within our data warehouse, within Service Manager. Bringing that in terms of Operations Manager is also using that capability. Virtual Machine Manager is using that. So now we can provide a holistic view of important data that we need to consolidate and bring into our Configuration Manager database. Now, when we think about our cube components or these cubes as we've talked about within Service Manager, we want to make sure that we think about this in a number of ways. We have our dimensions and our measures groups. And when we do that, we can apply or identify who are those numeric values, those calculated values. Or, for example, a percent of time in a critical state. That's something that we want to make sure that we're very mindful of and that we pull that information in. And then we have the attributes to be able to analyze those measures. When we do that, we're able to provide rich reporting. Whether we surface that on Excel dashboards or SharePoint dashboards, it doesn't matter. It's all about that underlying cube that we then want to analyze. And within Service Manager, we're able to step into our reports view and be able to analyze those cubes or analyze that data as we need to. For instance, we saw that with the chargeback mechanism or the chargeback cube. We've also seen that with the incident management cube as well. So that's something that you can take advantage of leveraging within your console. Now, when we think about SharePoint, we have our SharePoint Performance Point services within 2013, where we can slice and dice that information upon need. And it gives us a click once, easy design for end user type of view, where they can now really see how am I performing against certain incidents? What are the incidents that are most critical? What are the problems that are occurring most often? What are the services that are being requested the most? What are the resources that are being tasked the most within the environment? Because I'm seeing these alerts because I'm already brought in that integration with Orchestrator from Operations Manager who is doing that reporting and pulling in that information. So for example, let me think about my service desk scenarios. And this is something that we hear about a lot. We want to make sure that we build an incident dashboard or an incident view in terms of what are the most critical ones that we want to monitor and have insights on from an internal view within IT. What are the biggest incidents that I'm approaching? For instance, if you're looking here on the slide, you'll notice I have configuration data problems, or I have email problems, or I have hardware problems. Those types of things may be something that may occur quite often. Or I may actually see that I can break these out by categories and look at where I'm green or where I'm actually not doing so bad. You can get a pie chart type of view in terms of that as well to really give you a perspective on how much of your services or infrastructure is allocated to a particular resource. Now, when I come into Performance Point from the components perspective, and this is after I've already captured all of this data that I've brought into Service Manager or into the data warehouse, I can now start to think about building out the SharePoint experience and providing KPIs or filters or those reports or dashboards or what are these indicators or scorecards. That's something that's really key to helping us being able to measure what that looks like. I can then do that with this KPI. It compares actual against a goal and displays the indicators. I can then think about how the KPIs play against those dimensions and the version and the view of a scorecard per se. Or in the report, I can look at graphs and pie charts and data tables and visual diagrams. And then I can then just filter that data. And ultimately, bundling that up all together within the dashboard, it helps me able to provide a one-page view internally that I can point people to in real time. How are these incidents or how are these problems, how are these issues coming up in the environment? Or if I'm looking at chargeback, how is my chargeback environment or my cloud environment being utilized? Who is utilizing it? What are they using it for? Who are my top cost centers? Are my top users, et cetera? That's something that I can really start to take advantage of when I start to implement the capabilities within SharePoint. So, as a primary benefit to IT, once I built out all of these service issues or service infrastructure that I want to build, whether it be the service catalog, service requests, request offerings, etc., I'm also thinking about how does this impact my underlying infrastructure? What do I need to build in the future? Where do I need to de-invest? Where do I need to invest? Where do I need to expand, etc.? So capacity planning processes outlines that helps us outline that strategy, and we can apply the ITIL and MOF strategies to do that. Again, MOF is the Microsoft Operations Framework built on top of the ITIL processes. And the types of things that we can think about is business capacity planning, service capacity planning, component capacity planning as well. And that helps us to be able to build this into our processes and apply the next steps. So what questions have I identified? What questions do I need to ask of myself when I'm thinking about operational level analysis and thinking about that insight? Taking the internal view, me as IT, what are the future business and IT plans for this service? Once I identify a service, I'm going to be spinning up an environment or spinning up a cloud or a VM. What's the future use of this? Why do they care? What is the capacity requirements? I'm going to have more people wanting to move to this cloud-based or cloud usage scenario. If so, how do I need to plan out my underlying infrastructure? How can I maximize the use of this resource? And what are the historical trends of this data that I can start to take advantage of? And I can build into my storylines for my IT leadership teams. And then how can I meet the capacity predictions of the overall organization? This is where I can now flow between my internal view and external view for my key decision makers within the enterprise to make better decisions. So these are the things that I'm going to be answering within the OLA insights and reporting and getting that deep analysis and deep investment to make a better decision across the enterprise. So as I sum this up, this is essentially the last of the component or the segments for the IT service management track. And what we've covered is SLA insights and analysis. It's all about what insights can I provide back to the enterprise, back to my leadership team within the enterprise or my individual business units or even tenants and users. And how can they make better decisions in their own charters to be more effective, be more productive? How do I standardize my service delivery model? Thinking about service requests and service offerings and request offerings and surfacing that on the self-service experience portals so that now I can have that service catalog available on demand to my users and it can scale in a varying of ways across my user base. Some users can see certain types of offerings, certain other users can see a different set. Now I want to bring and start to manage my multiple ITIL-like processes, incident and problem management, change management, release management, my SLAs, putting that people processes in place to complement the technology or the components within service manager, orchestrator, operations manager, virtual machine manager, configuration manager, and even data protection manager and app controller. Collectively as a management stack on top of the foundation layer with Windows Server, I'm now able to manage a better infrastructure, cloud and data center infrastructure, whether that be on-prem, in the public cloud with Azure or across service provider environments. And then lastly, my OLA insights helps me to be able to keep my finger on the pulse internally within IT so that I can provide better trending analysis, forecasting, and better reporting on service and incident requests and those types of things, where those problems are, where could they potentially occur, and to predict those changes in the environment. Because as the enterprise grows, the IT needs to shift appropriately, and that insight helps me to be able to do that. So that's what we've covered with IT service management, and I thank you for joining me. But before I go, I want to make sure that you definitely jump over into the TechNet Evaluation Center, where you can start to really download the product, get your hand on System Center 2012 R2, and take advantage of the things we've talked about in IT service management with Service Manager. Then start to expand and play with Orchestrator, play with Operations Manager, Virtual Machine Manager, and some of those other products within the stack to really learn how you can take advantage of managing a better data center cloud solution. Then I also recommend that you take a look at our virtual labs on TechNet, where we have this hands-on technical environment where you can work at your own pace and go step by step to configure some of the things that we've talked about here today. And then, of course, I encourage you to come back to Microsoft Virtual Academy and learn more about the other four product capabilities that we have in market today for System Center 2012 R2. Again, my name is Brandon Matherson. I'm a product marketing manager, and I really appreciate your time. Please come back and join us. Thanks.